Tonight, it does appear that Labor Day weekend tourism is down in some parts of the Granite State that were hard hit by Irene. With the storm forcing the state to shut down roads earlier in the week to make repairs, there was the perception that you can't get there from here. But after long hours and hard work by many road crews, many of those roads have reopened. And as Mike Garrity shows us from Waterville Valley.
We're here on Route 49 in Waterville Valley. This is one of many roads here in the state that was impacted by Irene. You can see the Jersey barriers here. But the state has worked hard to get this road open. In fact, Waterville Valley businesses say they are open for business. However, this holiday weekend, they're seeing an impact.
This would have been full. The campground, all of them would have been full. All the way down to the Kangamangas to here. Yeah.
When Irene hit, this stream that runs through Waterville Valley's Osceola campground became swollen, forcing the campground to shut down.
If I didn't move my trailer, it would have been downstream.
The campground reopened Friday, but many people had already canceled their Labor Day weekend reservations, so now campsites are available.
It's bad. As you can see, it's supposed to be full. It's supposed to be full, and we only got probably seven people here.
In town Saturday night, we did find a crowd gathered for live music, but here too, many say they've seen an impact.
I think occupancy is off because of the storm. I think that people had the perception that Waterville Valley was not open because of the damage done to Route 49.
But what we found last night, we were up 20% above last year. The evening's not over yet. I'm down a little bit right now, but I'm hoping that we can come back and be up.
And I think people had trouble at home too. You know, Rhode Islanders were without power for 4 or 5 days.
With the lackluster economy and gas about a dollar higher than Labor Day last year, AAA had expected a 2.3% drop in New England travel for Labor Day, but that was before Irene.
I think it's down 10%. But we'll be back up in October for Columbus weekend.
Of course, this holiday weekend is not over yet, but it will take some time before the economic data is available to see what the impact was. In the meantime, business owners here in Waterville Valley, they have one message they're trying to get out. They're open for business. In Waterville Valley, Mike Garrity, WMUR News 9.